Hello everyone, welcome to our channel. Recently we announced our new junior team, so it's time to get to know our new players a little bit more. So welcome Maxi Magic and Dima Demon. You should already have seen Demon playing for Navi Youth, and now it's like new chapter begins. So enjoy watching. Hello guys.
Hello.
Demon, first of all, I want to ask you about changes. Now you are part of the new Navi junior roster and you communicate with your teammates and the coach as well in English. What the transition to another language difficult for you?
Not really, because I like started trying my English like from the first grade. It's like just hard to try and understand everyone, because like you have Kairi, who has like who is Spanish, and it's and his difficult is, I don't know, it's the difficult one. But now it's, I think it's okay.
I see. Max, what about you? Have you ever had such an experience before Navi?
Not really, but I just used to play many Faceit packs, and like I'm not really feeling uncomfortable when I'm speaking English. Like it's fine for me.
Can you tell me about your previous team?
That was like kind of mix. We just like were playing Faceit, and then one moment we chose to create kind of team. We registered for ISEA. We played ISEA Open, after ISEA Intermediate, after ISEA Main, like step by step. And after that 4 month way, I got into Navi Junior team. So yeah, that's all.
We will speak about it for sure, but first of all, I want to ask you about your childhood. Do you remember your first video game which you played?
I do remember, and it was Lineage 2. Because my dad was playing it, and like I was looking at him, and as every child, I guess, I wanted to play same as my father does, and like I was playing it, and I enjoyed it. I didn't really understand what's the sense of the game, but in general, I liked it.
Dima, have you ever played Lineage?
No, I don't know about this game. maybe it's like some strategy, but I'm not sure.
Something like that. But after this interview, you can try this game with your new teammate, and I'm sure Max will share all experience with you.
Yeah, of course, we can play together after.
Okay, Max, what about CS World? When did you first start playing CSGO?
CSGO, that was 2018, April, 1st of April. Mm-hmm. I bought it for $15, I guess, in Steam. I played matchmaking. I got Gold Nova 4, and yeah, that was my kind of start of my way, I would say.
Have you ever tried the old version, for example, like CS 1.6, 1.2, Source, for example?
Yeah, I was playing CS 1.6, like in probably 2015, 2016. At the time, I played Minecraft as well. But 1.6, I was playing like on public servers where you just join and there are more 20 more people like besides you, and
like a mess.
Yeah, and it wasn't really CS, but that was like
that was cool,
and yeah, that's how I was playing.
When did you realize that you want to be a part of the competitive scene?
I realized that when I was playing with my friends, and I was I would say a bit better than any one of them. I just understand that like maybe one day I can become a like really really good player, and I just was playing like more and more, and I was getting better and better, and like yeah, that's it.
How did you come up with your nickname? Why Magic?
Actually, I have no clue, to be honest. I just like in one moment I just chose to be Magic, and like I don't know why. There is no reason, actually. I just for fun.
How did your parents react to your decision to become a pro player? Did they support you or argue with you about it?
That's a very tough question.
Like always.
Like, I don't know, I was playing, and there were always problems like you need to study, you need to get work, etc, etc. But after I got to Navi Junior team, I showed it to my mom, and she was like,
maybe something
will happen, like, and yeah, now there is like no problem, I would say.
How did you become part of our team? I think it happened thanks to Road to Navi, didn't it?
Actually, like I did send the application to Navi, but I don't know what happened. It didn't come to them. But how I was playing tryouts, that's actually, it's not about application, but just one day I was playing Faceit solo, and our coach Kairi, he has like Spanish friends, which are like pro players, or they were professional players before, like in the past. And I was playing against them, and they said that I'm cheating, like I'm using radar hack or something
Seriously?
Like this. Yeah, and after they... I guess they like wrote to Kairi that, hey, there is like some strange guy that he looks like he's playing with cheats or something like this. And he added me in Steam and asked if I wanted to play tryouts to Navi Junior. And I said, yes, of course.
You was talking about tryouts. What does the test period look like?
Actually, it looked like there were many people and like every day there were changes, like for example one day you are playing with one player and the second day you are playing like with another, yeah, and we were just like playing 3-4 packs, like we were mixing the teams, I mean Kairi was mixing the teams, like yeah, and we were just playing and he was observing us, I would say, and he was just watching how we play, and yeah, that's it.
Mm-hmm. Okay, Demon, we knew you like a player of the previous junior roster and after that like youth player. How did you know that now you are a new junior player again?
I was speaking to Zemiran, maybe the week from tryouts. I didn't know that I will be on these tryouts. And after these tryouts, Zemiran just said you're gonna be like in the next roster.
Can you say that's like a challenge for you because of the English language?
Not really, just like a great opportunity because from now I can play a lot of tournaments because I'm recently turned to 16 and it's kinda new world opened to me. And yes, in previous roster I can play because of the age of my previous teammate, and yeah, it was some tilting.
But have you noticed that it affected you and your communication in general? That you need a few seconds to translate all information or calls which you want to share with your teammates or something like that?
Not really, because like as I said before, I was studying English from first grade with my extra teacher or something like this, and step by step, and now I can just, it's easier to speak me in English. Because I it's already like in my head, I don't know.
I know that you continue to develop your English skills, and I know it for sure because we have the same teacher and she told me about it. Okay guys, do you remember your first team conversation in TeamSpeak, for example?
To be honest, I don't remember.
Seriously?
As I remember, we just meet up and we are just decided by rules who are playing where, and that's all I think. They just talked about who is captain, which maps you're gonna train, and some stuff like this.
Okay, I see. Can you describe your teammates in a few words?
Makazi is unbeamed shift. FNL is GL, like from main roster. Krabeni, rich guy.
Krabeni, rich guy, okay.
I agree with Demon that FNL is like GL in the main roster. He's like just hyping up, you know, we are winning some clutch or some crazy round, I don't know. And he's like screaming and everyone is, I would say happy, just happy, yes, because of him. Makazi is plus W, but this guy is shooting actually really insane. Like, I don't know why, and I can say the same about Demon, like when I'm spectating them both, they're like, I don't know, aim machine, you know, like you're just spectating them and you just cannot understand how is it possible to shoot that good. They're just like destroying like everybody on the server, yeah. And about Krabeni, I would say he's just like a calm guy, very... very focused, I would say.
And what about Demon?
He's very good at shooting.
And that's all.
Nice to hear. Nice to hear it. I think you already have a lot of experience working with coaches. That's why you can compare your current coach with previous coaches. What you can say about Kyrie?
It's kind of hard because we're just have a team like maybe 3 weeks or something like that, and just it's kind of hard, but for me it's good, and sometimes sometimes he's saying really good things.
Kyrie is very smart and he just reads the game, and he's very good at understanding the game, and yeah, that's it.
What useful things, tip or tricks have you learned from him?
The smog, the molo, the nate. I always hear Magic use nates. So I'm learning a lot of stuff.
For me, he's more disciplined. I don't know how to say it, because everywhere I just want to, if I get some multi-kills, I want to just go run and shoot. But he's every time just screaming freeze, stop, and this stuff.
Yeah, that's true.
Okay, how much time did you have for training before your first championship?
Not really much. You have first weekend we just play some pracs, got played maybe some maps, 2 or 3, just by small describe them, and on the next week we have I don't remember, 2 or 3 championship. We didn't play a lot of practice, and we from instantly have instantly championship, and it was kind of hard.
By the way, how many hours per day do you usually spend on CS2?
Team trainings maybe around 6 or 7 hours. I'm not really spending a lot of self-training, I'm just playing this match that I take by mood, because I don't know, face it, it's so shit for me.
Okay, Max, what about you?
Yeah, team trainings is 7 hours we have.
Mm-hmm.
And I actually play all the time. I'm just waking up, maybe going to school, depends on the day.
Maybe, I'm not sure about it.
After we have team training, and after that I'm chilling probably for 40 minutes, and I'm playing Deathmatch or even maybe Face It. I agree with Demon that it's not the best CS, I would say, but I'm just playing it, and I enjoy it.
By the way, is CS2 good enough for the pro scene right now? And do you like this version more than CSGO?
I hate this version.
Hey?
Yes.
Nice.
I don't know, because maybe on LAN tournaments is good because everyone has the same ping, but from other people, I said that it's shit on LAN also. And it's need to time, but I don't know, I really hate this game. It's so, it depends now on lucky.
Max, what do you think about CS2?
Yeah, actually, I like this game, a lot.
Oh, nice.
But,
thanks.
That's only about the things that there are many bugs, many things that, need to be fixed, yeah? And but in general, I like it. It looks cool.
But it's just beginning. I think developers will fix every bug or troubles in this version, for sure. Do you still play CS:GO sometimes?
No, I don't.
There is no reason to play CS:GO.
Yeah, doesn't make any sense.
What about nostalgia? Because you grew up with this game, something like that.
It's just zero sense, because we need to focus on CS2. Because we are now playing CS2, not CS:GO, and and there is nothing to do in CS:GO.
Mm-hmm. Okay, let's talk about your first championship, Sky Esports. How was it for you? Your mood before this qualification, atmosphere during this event, and so on.
For me, it was really bad tournament, because on trainings I was was showing good performance, but when the tournament started, I was really doing bad performance, and I was salty about it, because so many thoughts was in my head. And it was kind of distracting me from the game, and I was staying on focus all the tournament, and it was tilting for me extra.
Same for me, actually. I had many thoughts, and I was really, I would say, unfocused, but I didn't really play good, I would say. But if you are talking about like nervous or something like this, I wasn't really nervous that I was playing against some like teams. I was just focusing on my game and I was playing it, and like doesn't matter who am I playing against, but it's only about me. I just played bad, like, and yeah.
What you can say about participants of this championship?
I think that I thought that gonna win this like qualifier, because I know they're like on bootcamp for real long time, and it's not like bootcamp, they're living there, and it's like their roster have like already long time, and I thought they were gonna win this qualifier, but something happened, it didn't look for them.
I agree with Demon. I have nothing to say about it.
Anyway, I hope it's just beginning of your long path and we will see you on a big pro scene for sure. Okay, guys, what do you usually do when you don't have any training? I realize for sure that esports is your passion, but what else do you have? Studying, streaming, sports probably?
Maybe extra English lessons, and sometimes I'm just playing some other games. For example, maybe if you know, it's like Kovac, something similar to AimLab, and yeah, maybe some PUBG or Rust or something, or Dota, yes, a lot of
Rust,
Dota.
Dota?
PUBG.
Yes.
Nice. What about Minecraft?
No, time is already gone.
I'm playing only ECS, and like probably once for like 2 months, I would say, I'm playing Minecraft with my friends for probably 2 hours maximum, and like, yeah, but like I play only CS.
What about Dota, Valorant, for example?
Yeah, I tried Valorant when it only came up, like, I mean, when it was released, yeah, and I tried it. I played probably like 5 or 6 bugs, and after I deleted the game. And same with Dota, I just joined on server with bots, one bot killed me, and after I understood that it's not my game, and I deleted it as well. So like I have probably like 15 minutes in Dota 2 and like around 4 hours in Valorant, and yeah.
Yeah. Okay guys, now we can say a few words for all viewers who are watching this video right now.
Thank you for supporting us.
Thank you for watching the Navi Junior team, I would say. Follow the Twitch, guys.
Okay, Guy, thank you so much for this interview. I hope you good luck on your future championships, and see you next time. Thanks everybody for watching this video. I hope you enjoy it, and will not forget to subscribe to our channel. See ya.